But Crunchyroll is bad.
Hi, welcome back to another Princess Connect video. My name is Lace, and today we're going to be talking about a really awesome announcement, to be honest. We are getting a first month celebration gift, which is awesome. But what's more awesome is the rewards themselves, so I'm not going to freaking blue balls you. Let's just go right into it. Oh, baby. 800k mana, 300 stamina, 10 gacha tickets every day for 10 days, resulting in 8 million mana, 3,000 stamina, and 100 gacha tickets over this period of time. Guys, this is pretty incredible, to be honest. You just can't criticize this. They just gave out like a whole bunch of free stuff. There's a lot of ways to interpret this. A, it could be like Crunchyroll has turned a new leaf from their past ways, and they are now showering us with stuff. B, Cygames is making them do stuff like this. Look, whichever one it is out of these two options, I'll friggin' take it. And C, the less ventured path, and it's that the game is dying already. Look, guys, it's like 2 months in. I really doubt the game is dying right now. If you really do think that, I urge you to, you know, give it the benefit of the doubt. This is a good thing. If anything, this level of generosity is only going to attract more players. Like, oh my gosh, this is incredible. Even for like normal gacha games, they don't just give out 100 tickets in the first month. I said Crunchyroll was stingy. Well, I take it back now. It's at this point in time, they're freaking generous. I personally think this really makes up for the accelerated schedule, like 100 tickets. That's a third of a pity. And very shortly, I'm going to talk about how I'm feeling about these gacha tickets, where you should put them. But at this point in time, let me just keep like, you know, get down on my knees and praise the Lord for a little bit, you know? Crunchyroll to date seems to have handled Princess Connect pretty well. Honestly, almost all of my concerns have been met. Yeah, pretty much all of them. I can't think of anything off the top of my head that I'm like mad about. They are doing really well. And I don't say this to the benefit of Crunchyroll, though Crunchyroll is benefiting, and you know, if you guys want to sponsor me, hit me up. But I say this to the benefit of the players mainly, because like, you know, if you have confidence in a publisher like Crunchyroll to deliver this good product with all of this awesome stuff, you're just going to be having a better time in general, to be honest. What this means for the whales is that this kind of gives assurance that the game may be like, you know, it's going to be growing. For the free to players, this means that we get a chance, you know. It's that gap between like each spending grade, like it's, you know, it's diminishing every time something like this happens. Guys, there's no way to spin it. This is a really, really good thing. All right, that's enough shilling for now. Like, you know, I'm not sponsored. I'm not paid by Crunchyroll. I honestly think I'm looking past all that history or whatever. Everything that they've done to date has been good. Okay, let's talk about these gacha tickets for a second. So we're going to be getting 100 gacha tickets essentially. What this means is that we actually get some leeway for Summer Kiaru and Christina. However, if you've been saving quite well for them already and you're in a pretty like good established clan battle team, I would say that you could potentially drop some of this into either Ilya or Kyoka, or even Summer Pekarin, because I know y'all like that Pekko. Me personally, I think I'm going to use this as a bonus. I'm personally going to probably drop like maybe like 20, 30 into Kyoka and maybe a little bit into Ilya. I don't know. We'll see. But for the most part, I'm going to save this just as a rainy day check for, you know, if I do not make it for Summer Kiaru, which I will, or if I don't make it for example, Christina. Honestly, guys, I'm looking at the timeline and I don't think the months are going to be right for this one, but like, this is just a good list. I reckon, you know, if you're going to drop on anything, it's still hard to recommend dropping on Kyoka and Ilya. And the reason why is because you look at it this after all that, right? And it just gets a bit wild. Look at all of those limited. So the green or the purple or literally anything that's not white is pretty much like stuff that you should be rolling on that's not Kyoka and Ilya. Like, we've got other higher priority targets like New Year's Yui over here and Valentine Shizuru. Granted, they are a little bit further out, but especially on an accelerated schedule, it just becomes laughable to roll on Kyoka and Ilya. However, if you are a very serious arena battler, I would probably pick up Ilya. And if you are in like a top 10 or top 25 clan, I probably would consider Kyoka. Again, situations reversed, I probably wouldn't go for Ilya if you're clan battle focused, for example, unless you're willing to 5-star her. And even then, as you guys know, there's just so much good stuff that's coming up, right? Like, I have no faith in my RNG, like, to be honest. I'm expecting to spark Kiaru. I'm expecting to spark New Year's Yui, Christina. That's already like 45. That's 135k. And we've got Shizuru up here as well, so I'm personally going to try to save as much of it as I can. Unfortunately, this first year is just going to be brutal, that Shizuru. But what I didn't show after is that Muimi comes right after the Shizuru. Like, oh my gosh. With that being said, it always comes back to the same point, and it's that, you know, if you're getting bored because you're holding on for too long, which a lot of people, it happens, especially to the casual players. If you're a casual player, just go spend some cash, my dudes. Part of the thrill of the game is the progression, and if you're not progressing anymore, or like you're not getting new characters and stuff, it just gets really boring really fast. And and I completely understand that. So to be honest, all in all, nothing's changed. My recommendations are still largely the same. It's just that maybe if you're feeling a little lucky, you know, pop it into Kyoka, pop it into Ilya. I probably wouldn't recommend popping into Arisa at this point. Arisa is good, but Kyoka and Ilya, in my opinion, are better. Except, however, here's the caveat. Kyoka doesn't thrive until you get Summer Kyaru, so it's more like an investment than anything. Arisa, on the other hand, she will thrive for all of these months up until a Summer Kyaru and beyond. But yeah, that's kind of where my head's landed at. I'm pretty sure I'm just gonna hold. I might dump a few into Kyoka. I'm probably gonna skip Ilya now. Yeah, I need to make sure that I get Christina and Summer Kyaru. Guys, I think that's it. Like, to be honest, guys, like, this is so hype. This is so hype, not only because, like, you know, they've done this once, but, like, everything put together, I have a good feeling about this. I have a good feeling about this game. And honestly, this was really, like, ad lib or ad hoc or whatever. It just came out of nowhere, right? And they could potentially do this again. And if this keeps up, if they just kind of have these, like, over and over, like, over time, like, maybe every 3 months or something like that, we won't feel that accelerated schedule. I mean, we will, but we will feel only the benefits of it, because we'll also be, like, kind of, like, compensated with the mana, the stamina, and the gacha tickets. Honestly, this is best case scenario. I really think this is best case scenario. All right, guys, I think you guys can tell I can't contain my excitement about this. I'm going to wrap it up before I keep rambling. Guys, on top of this, something special has happened for us on this channel as well. We hit 2K subs, and that is awesome. Thank you guys so much for supporting me all of this way. And this is a feel-good video, guys. This is a feel-good video. It means a lot to me that you guys enjoy this content. I admit, I don't get everything right, right? I don't get everything right. If somebody ever corrects me in the comments, and it's happened a lot of times, I admit I'm wrong, and I will pin that post, or, you know, like, I try to just tell everyone what I know. I am trying my best here, and a lot of you are liking it, and I really appreciate that. Thank you guys so much for sticking around. From here, I do have, like, a couple of plans to broaden out a little bit. You know, I want to do some reviews of some of my favorite, like, gachas. I really love Blue Archive. I just haven't been able to play it. I love Arknights. I love Genshin, stuff like that. Just some really superficial stuff that we can all talk about, right? Like, you know, I initially went into Genshin thinking it was going to be, like, shit roll rates, and, okay, you know what? I can save that for another video. Oh god, I actually rambled again. Okay, I'm really sorry, guys, but let's wrap it up here. Secret message is Crunchyroll Redemption Arc. If you guys could drop that message down in the comments below, I would really, really appreciate it. It lets me know that you've made it to the end of the video, and that is just super hype. It makes me feel like my work has been appreciated. Thank you guys again so much for 2K. There are so many watch hours. You guys have consumed, like, so much of my content. We've got this. We've only got good things ahead. I am very, 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 very optimistic. Guys, as always, thank you guys so much for watching. Like, subscribe, comment, share, you know the works, and come catch me on my Discord if you need some help. But other than that, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.